The Laviolette discussion we were just having, is this one of the more underrated coaches in our league, do you think, Mark?
Oh, I have to agree 100%. He's a real player's coach. And when you have that, guys love coming to the rink and playing for you. And, you know, 600 wins proves that. He's had a great career thus far. You know, the only thing that he's missing is that Stanley Cup, and he's got the right team to try and accomplish that this season.
Right. I'm looking at the other side now, and I see that Colorado has now lost 11 of 14 games. Sid and I were looking at each other in the middle of that game saying, are the Avs good enough? I know their top line is good enough. Is the rest of the Avs good enough? And is Semyon Varlamov good enough to make a good run and put themselves in a spot to be a playoff team?
Yeah, I think it's finally caught up to the Avalanche. That top line could only carry them for so long. And unfortunately now, their time looks like it's coming to an end. They need more depth. Varlamov proves at times he can be a great number one, but he has too many nights off. And this is a real Avalanche team that's searching right now. And they're going to need to add someone at the deadline, a big name, maybe a Mark Stone, if they can afford his salary next year. That'd be a nice pickup for them to add some depth, some scoring depth that they need badly.
You think Colorado could make another deal with Ottawa? I think everyone in Ottawa is like, leave us alone. Leave us alone.
Yeah, maybe try and get that first-round pick back if they can.
Good luck. Good luck. All right. Well, there's the first-round pick is gone. Some other things are either have already left or are leaving Edmonton right now. One of them could be playoff hopes. But let's go through what happened today for the Edmonton Oilers. Just today. For the Edmonton Oilers. Tim, correct me if I miss anything here.
Okay.
Ryan Spooner was placed on waivers.
Correct.
Ty Ratty. Placed on waivers. Connor McDavid basically said, if guys are in this room who don't think we make the playoffs, they got to get out of here.
We'll play that in a sec.
Yep. And just now before we came on,
Caleb Jones.
They sent down Caleb Jones to Bakersfield. And oh, yeah, there's a new number one goalie in Edmonton. It is not Cam Talbot. Within the last couple of minutes, Elliot Friedman is reporting Mikko Koskinen, get ready for it, has been given a 3-year extension. Worth $4.5 million per year. Both Koskinen and Talbot were in the final years of their contracts. This just breaking in the last little bit. Mark, first word to you is, have you seen enough out of Mikko Koskinen to give him a 3-year deal to be a number one guy?
This is unbelievable right now, and you know, and I like Peter Chiarelli. He was my general manager in Boston, but things have gone off the rails in Edmonton for sure. There must be something else happening today that we don't know about yet that might drop any minute, because this is amazing. To give a guy a 4.5, you know, a year deal for 3 years, and like you said, this is his first year in the National Hockey League. Sure, he's had a decent body of work so far, but that's got to say that, you know, Talbot's the odd man out here, and they're going to move him by the trade deadline. All these guys leaving Oilers land, and now McDavid comes out telling, you know, if you don't want to be here, you know, tell somebody and leave, and then Ratty goes on waivers and Spooner. It's a messy situation out there, but there's got to be something else happening in the next little bit before their next game.
Yeah, I think a lot of the speculation right now is that Cam Talbot is obviously the odd man out. But I was just looking a couple days ago, Edmonton Journal, I saw this headline. Brian Burke was talking with Bob Stauffer locally and basically said that he believes Cam Talbot has no trade value. The hard truth from Brian Burke.
Hard truth.
Yeah, this is a hard truth. Mm-hmm. And I don't know. I mean, listen. I don't know where they go from here. Obviously, that money can come off the books, and if you can look beyond this year, you could probably say, well, I understand what this is. This is a $4 million goalie. You can't have two $4 million goalies. But for fans in that city right now, it has got to be remarkably frustrating to look at another guy who, at a point, looked like he could be a player and now has very little, no trade value.
Oh, it's so frustrating, and exactly it. You know, Berkey's not far off there. I don't know what you can get for this guy right now besides maybe a draft choice. So it'll be interesting to see what the Oilers do. But this team's spinning its tires right now. You know, Ken Hitchcock's tried all kinds of different things with really nothing to work with. Let's be honest. Every night you look at the scoring from this hockey team, and McDavid's in on every goal. So this is a tough, tough situation in Edmonton right now, and I don't think there's any magic remedy to get out of this. They should maybe just look at being a seller this year.
Well, in terms of how you get out of it, Mark, let's go there next. Because last night, at one point, it was a 6-1 Canes lead on Sportsnet 1. Oilers made it respectable. It should have been never that close. So today, Ken Hitchcock and Connor McDavid and everyone spoke to the media. And Connor McDavid is fairly measured, I think it's safe to say, with what he says and how he says it. He knows how important he is. This was about as outspoken today as we have heard Connor McDavid regarding what's going on with the team and what's going on in that room. If you haven't heard this, it's good.
We hear the boos and we hear the stuff that's going on, but, we understand the fans are frustrated. We expect better out of ourselves, and they obviously expect better of us.
Is part of the challenge that some guys don't think that those 23 guys in there are the right group to be able to do that?
Well, if there's guys that believe that, then they should get out of the room. If you don't believe in this group and you're in the locker room, then you need to leave. So I don't get that sense. I don't feel that way. I think that everyone in there believes in each other and believes we'll get it done.
Savvy, are you surprised to hear that, and do you like it from the captain?
I love it from the captain. He's basically crying out to anybody that'll listen to bring some players in here. It's just a tough situation. There's not a lot going on, like I said, and when you can win some games, you lose some games. It's like a roller coaster up there, and I'm good friends with Milan Lucic, and he seemed to found a little bit of game of late, and I feel bad for him, the situation he's in. He signs that big deal, and he's not producing. There's not a lot Edmonton has to offer each night. There's no matchups there. No wonder McDavid's playing 22, 23 minutes. This is him just crying out for help to anybody that'll listen.
I mean, if you're a fan of this team, Mark, forgive me if I'm lost for words here, but I'm lost for words here.
I think we all are.
Because this is a team, they're only 3 points out of a playoff spot here. Avs just lost a big game, so they're still in that mix. They're only a point out of ninth. But, Mark, on the ice, off the ice, this is not a team that's acting like it has it together. Like, at some point, you have to exude to both your room and to the fan base that this isn't just a panic situation. But that's not really, correct me if I'm wrong, Tim and Mark, that's not what I'm seeing with this organization right now.
No, I'm seeing the same thing. And it's funny because we used to say this in our room ourselves when things were so bad. I don't have any answers. All I have is questions as well. So it's a tough situation. I'm lost for words as well. I don't know what to say right now.
The one good thing that maybe we can tie a bow on this if you are an Edmonton Oilers fan is that with the two players on waivers, it seems like they're trying to get some money back, which might mean Sequeira and Klefbom might be close to a return. And when you're talking about two guys that have done yeoman's work in this Oilers lineup, especially this year, Klefbom was averaging over 25 minutes a game when he went down. Like, you've seen a difference without him this year. But maybe there's the piece of good news for this team, is that they might get two defensemen that they need desperately back on this team.
Yeah, Klefbom was playing a huge role under the new regime from Ken Hitchcock. He can certainly help out. Sequeira can help out as well. They need to find a way not only to score more goals from other players, but they got to be able to keep it out of their net. And Koskinen, to his credit, has been the better of the two. I'm not sure he deserves that three-year deal already at 4.5. Maybe a little bit of a panic move on the Oilers. But like we said, too, I don't know where Cam Talbot fits in now. I don't know what you're going to get for him. But like you said, these two defensemen are definitely going to add a lot to this Oilers team. Let's face it, they're not out of a playoff position at all in that West.
3 points back. It's unbelievable.
Right.
I mean, the West is just packed.
And the way Leaf fans are talking about the team, you would feel they were in the same position. But that's not the case. Yeah. The Leafs obviously in a far better position, but there is panic. They've lost 7 of 10. Mark, I'm going to ask you about what happened today at Leafs practice. It might not hold over to the game coming up against the Capitals this week. But Mitch Marner was moved off of John Tavares' line today alongside Austin Matthews. Matthews, 1 goal in 13. Is that something that you think is necessary at this point? If you're Tavares, what are you reading that? What's your take?
Well, I've been saying this for a while now, and I don't know. I don't know if Babcock's finally listening. I say it on Leafs radio every night. That Austin Matthews needs to get more minutes. I've had enough of this. Austin Matthews had enough of this. He's got to get out on the ice and give his team an opportunity. He's the best, he's the guy that they're building this team around. He's the man. And 18 minutes a night, I'm sorry, that's not enough. So maybe the him playing with Mitch Marner, they're two best players, if you ask me, is going to bring more to this Leafs lineup on a nightly basis. But I think Mike Babcock has to find a way to get to get Austin Matthews, you know, more ice time. He's 41 in the NHL right now in forwards at 18 minutes and 7 seconds. I just took the top four guys in the league in scoring right now. Kucherov, 19-22. Gaudreau, 20-22. Rantanen, 21-07. And McDavid, 22-45. I know they don't have a good supporting cast as, you know, as Matthews does, but he has to get more minutes on a nightly basis. He has to be at the top. You know, he missed 14 games this year. He's got tons of energy. He's not going to burn out before the playoffs. I want him at 20 to 22 minutes a night at least.
I know it's panic in Leafland, and those points that you're bringing up are very valid and very interesting. Is this just part of a team taking step? Like, I feel like Maybe I should be a little bit more worried about the Leafs scoring, but I look at them and I see some talent. I saw Matthews buzzing last night. Nothing went in, but he had a pretty good game. I think it was 10 shot attempts on goal in those limited minutes. Is this just adversity that this team might be able to build on? I go back to the Penguins. Two of their last three cups, there has been, you know, drama the year. They replaced a coach one year. We had them for dead the other year, and they reeled off back-to-back cup wins. The Capitals last year, I mean, they were a goal away from going down to the Columbus Blue Jackets. Can this be one of those rallying points for Leafs Nation where they look back and say, maybe something was learned here?
Well, it certainly can, Tim. I think that's a great point. You know, anytime you go through adversity in a season, especially at this point, and you get over it and you come out stronger, you always come out stronger from it. And I think this team, you know, is at the bottom of the barrel right now. I think early in the year, if you recall, things were coming real easy to them.
Yeah.
They were winning games, and this might have caught up with them right now. They're in some games, and they don't know what to do. So hopefully this adversity, like you said, gets them ready for a big playoff run, because I think it will. And I think, you know, the one thing that bothers me, though, and I know it's bothered a lot of Leaf fans, is William Nylander. He's come into this lineup, and I think he's ruined the chemistry with all the lines. We had lines just rolling, and it was trying to get Willie going. Where do we put him? What do we change? And they changed all kinds of things, and it kind of seemed to put a little bit of a rut in everybody's game. So right now, if you were asking me, another thing I would do, not only putting Matthews and Marner together, I would put Willie on the fourth line like he was the other night, but leave him there and let him play some power play time until he gets out of this funk that he's in.
Yeah.
4 points in 20 games for William Nylander since returning.
One goal,
but you know what? He's going to pull out of it. I'm a positive guy. I think he's going to pull through.